This is the World of Sports Network presentation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's the G to the U to the R to the U. So we're going to hit the Green Bay Packers rookie draft class today. So we're going to hit it off the top. We're going to start with Jordan Love. This controversial pick at quarterback for the first round for the Green Bay Packers. I think it's just that time. You guys know me. I'm not a big Aaron Rodgers fan. I think he's overrated. I think he's going to be one of the most underachieving great athlete of our time. But anyhow, that's time for another subject. So Jordan Love should be coming in there taking his spot. I predict this is going to probably happen in a year. It might happen quicker if Aaron Rodgers gets smacked and miss a couple of games this year and Jordan Love do anything successful. But I'm going to show you all in a couple of highlights why Jordan Love is going to be a great, great pickup and a great transition when Aaron Rodgers leave the Green Bay Packers. Now, let's roll the tape. Love what the Packers did. This kid got arm strength. Look at this beautiful throw right there. Jordan Love really got absolutely out of this universe arm strength. He might have been a late first round draft pick, but he has elite round. He probably had the best arm strength in this entire draft out of all this quarterback. Look at that precision he put there. There's always something about his accuracy. You hear a lot of stuff like that. But one thing is, just like Josh Allen coming out of college, he's going to have a professional coaching. Look at this door right here, man. He has the tool set. He has all the tools and resources to be a very effective quarterback. We saw what Matt LaFleur saw, what Kyle Shanahan and the Green Bay Packers did to him. I mean, they got annihilated in both games, bro. In both games over there in San Francisco. And Aaron Rodgers really didn't do absolutely nothing. They're switching that offense, man. You know, and they need a guy like Jordan Love who's more coachable. You can mold a little bit better than Aaron Rodgers, who's stuck in his ways with his passive aggressive ways of doing things. So I love this pickup. I actually had Jordan Love as my number two ranked quarterback. I think when everything's said and done, Green Bay Packers are going to be very excited with the transition they're going to make from Aaron Rodgers to Jordan Love, man. Great draft decision by the Packers organization. Now, let's move on to the next. Man, A.J. Dillon is no joke, bro. The Packers are absolutely moving to a run-oriented offense. That's why they drafted Boston College A.J. Dillon in round two of the draft. They saw what the 49ers did to him. They saw the Tennessee Titans power game. Matt LaFleur have association with those type of organization. So yes, with the way they drafted, especially with this pick of A.J. Dillon, a 240-pound plus bruiser that just likes to run straight and run through you, that indicates that this is going to be a run-oriented offense with this signing. So I'm going to show you a couple of highlights on what A.J. Dillon is going to bring to Lambeau Field and the Green Bay Packers organization. Now let's roll the tape.
You can tell Green Bay is switching their offensive scheme to a power back. Drafting A.J. Dillon early in the second round, this is a big bruiser. Over 245 pounds of just mammoth man coming at you. Everybody saw the Tennessee Titans run last year with Derrick Henry. The Packers saw exactly what the 49ers did with the combination of their running back. They got straight bloodshed in both games versus the 49ers. They just got manhandled, man. They got their manhood tested. And A.J. Dillon is the back that's going to test a lot of people's manhood. Look at what number 11 just did, number 17. His manhood was just tested right here. If you want to come and make a tackle against A.J. Dillon in the fourth quarter, oh my God, you're going to have a lot of decisions to make. You might be making business decisions, man. A.J. Dillon is, I love how they're doing it. Like I said, those guys don't want to get their ass smacked like they did against the 49ers. You watch that two games against the 49ers, it was just a pure offensive line and a pure running game that destroyed the Green Bay Packers. So you know what? LaFleur is like, you know what we're going to do? We're going to go get our own version. So the drafting of A.J. Dillon is definitely an indication that the Green Bay Packers is moving into a more run-oriented offensive system.
One of the biggest draft needs for Green Bay was the tight end position. So they went to Cincinnati, man. They went to the third round. Why not? Cincinnati's producing hella tight ends lately, man. So they went over there and got Josiah, one of the best as far as blocking and receiving tight end in this entire draft. He's better at blocking than receiving, but he's still adequate as far as the passing and receiving game. So I'm going to show you a couple of highlights on how Josiah's going to fit into the new Mike LaFleur offensive system. So y'all just Roll the tape.
The third round pick, the Packers selected tight end Josiah from, can't really pronounce his last name, man. So I'm not gonna chop it up from Cincinnati. Very multi-faceted tight end, man. I put up a couple of tape on him. The dude could block, he could block, and also he could do this. This is what Aaron Rodgers really want from this guy. You know, like I mentioned, LaFleur and them saw exactly what the 49ers did as far as they annihilated them. So you know what? If you can't beat them, you better try to mimic them. So now they went to Cincinnati and got their own version of a Cincinnati tight end. So we have our boy over here, Josiah, who's going to come in and obviously be Aaron Rodgers' red zone target. The kid is a player, man. I saw a couple of plays the kid could play. Like I said, one of the good things is he could block. So we're going to need that, especially with the new offense they're running over there with with LaFleur, going with the zone scheme with Shanahan, the power game, with the zone blocking scheme. So add that with this guy making catches. So I like that pick over there, man. That's one of the first picks in this entire draft that really indicate that the offense of the Packers is going to be a little bit different moving into next year. Now let's move to the next highlighted pick for the Green Bay Packers.
All right, man. The interior side of the Green Bay Packers offensive line was very, very shaky. And obviously, they were jealous because they saw LaFleur saw one of his best friends, Shanahan. He saw his offense. He saw his linemen. He saw what they did to him. Totally demolished him. So with 3 6-round pick, man, you know I'm calling it 666. I got to call him a 666. With Jon Runyan, Jake Hanson, and my boy over there from Indiana. What's his name, man? What's the body more? Simon Stepaniak. I can't even say his last name. But anyways, the Packers went in there, LaFleur and company went in there and tried to solidify their interior lineman by signing all three of those guys. So now the Packers are gonna be set. That means they wanna run the ball in your face. Obviously they got AJ Dillon, so they wanna run straight. They're not trying to be cute. So they went in the sixth round and got themselves a left guard, got themselves a center, and got themselves a right guard off the TOP. So that indicates, show you that the Packers are trying to run straight at you and they're not even trying to be cute about it. That's what the Packers are doing, man. So I'm gonna show a couple of highlights of the new Green Bay Packers road grinders, man, because the Packers are gonna be grinders moving forward.
So now the offensive line for Green Bay, like I mentioned, you saw what happened. LaFleur and company, they saw what happened in the two games when they played the 49ers. So between all the six rounds, I called it the 3 6s. They went and secured the interior lineman, man. You need a lineman, you know, with the drafting of Michigan, Jon Runyan. Bro, if you draft any Runyan, you did a good job. I don't even want to see. If your name is a Runyan, your last name is a Runyan, I'll draft you too. Great pickup by the Green Bay Packers, man, with that draft pick. I also love the pick of center, Jake Hanson from Oregon. Look at this guy block, bro. I mean, the interior six, I call them, the three interior linemen in the sixth round for the Green Bay Packers. They're not playing around, man. Those guys want to get tougher. They want to show you that, hey, we're going to pound this ball. It's not about Aaron Rodgers anymore in Lambeau and in Green Bay. It's going to be the running game. It's going to be the offensive linemen. That's going to be what's going to be the key in Green Bay, and you're going to play hard-nosed defense. It's not about gunslinging Aaron Rodgers anymore, man. Great pickup by the Green Bay scouting department as far as the sixth round picks, man. I love that. That's what they should have done. That's the real indication that the offense has changed in Green Bay. The Aaron Rodgers offense led of change. It's going to be a ground and pound, and he's going to be a game manager. Y'all know that. That's why the Packers drafted Jon Runyan, Jake Hanson, and my man Simon from Indiana. Look at this tape right there, man. Look at this tape right there. Those guys are big bruisers. Big bruisers. Love that draft pick from the Green Bay Packers. The only things I love about their entire draft trip, to be honest with you.
Overall, if this works, I think it's going to be a building block for Mike LaFleur. And like I mentioned, I'm not a big Aaron Rodgers fan. And I think this could actually work. You can never go wrong. I'm an old school classic guy. You can never go wrong with a great running game and a great defense. And the great defensive Packers, the Green Bay Packers are definitely going by that blueprint. Y'all know the drill. Like this, love this, share this, and I am out.